the enemies. And we have the Lighthouse Award. Now, when this was originally started, it was really the one who started it. He was thinking in terms of, you know, the wonders of the world, and the lighthouse in Alexandria. And he said, you know, a guiding light. But what this has really become is what happens below the guiding light. This award is for the people that work really hard, that really make a difference, and don't get credit for it. So this is what I can tell you right now. If you're famous, you're not going to get the award. If you make a lot of money, you're going to be more happy than the people who are famous, but you're not going to get the award. If you don't have money and you're not famous, you're in the running right now. So I want you to be ready. Now, one other piece of advice. Last time, we sort of went through this sort of dog and pony story. Relax. We went through this dog and pony deal, and we said, you know, this is for business or government or whatever, but it's not for anyone in the media. By which some of the media got up and started leaving, and Katie Hayes had to run down and tackle her, you know, you know who I'm talking about, and to make sure she stayed. So this can go to anyone. It's the people that really make a difference in the trade community. You don't get the credit for the day-to-day. Sarah.
Yeah. So, Bill, you know, I have some interesting factoids to maybe present tonight. So, did you know that nearly one quarter of all fireworks are imported during the month of June?
I wonder why.
I mean, AmericanPyro.com says so.
You know, another thing I didn't realize, but do you know that the tariffs on products coming from Cambodia are 170 times higher than the tariffs coming from Saudi Arabia, which shocked me because last time I checked, Saudi Arabia is a rather rich country, and Cambodia really isn't.
Yeah, I mean, it's amazing when we have these little factoids at our fingertips how, you know, it really explains very articulately some of the trade problems we face. And, you know, I have a little factoid about our honoree tonight.
Okay,
so, you know, this is little known, but our honoree tonight was a Pac-10 varsity gymnast. Stanford.
He must be a very athletic, tall, great
worker. But you want to randomly say athletes. He competed with Tim Daggett and Mitch Gaylord and no, Ambassador Froman, you already got your award.
Well, you know, the other thing about him is he's an author. You know, he's got a USTR background. He worked for one of the most important senators in the history of the Senate, Max Baucus. And he wrote a book, Freedom from Want. And he wrote this book when nobody was focusing on trade. In fact, if I was a new USTR, let's say that was my new job, I would say, boy, my entire staff should read this. I should go out tomorrow morning and buy this book, Freedom from Want. And if I wanted to get the Lighthouse Award next year, I would probably go out and buy that as well. So that's just a hint. But it's a terrific book. And let me just tell you one thing, because I actually read this book. During the Smoot-Hawley debate, the goldfish industry actually became engaged because they were scared that duty-free goldfish coming in from Japan could overwhelm the U.S. goldfish industry, and they prevailed. And that's why we named the Herbert Hoover Building next door. So, I mean, the point is, sometimes you got to stand up for the goldfish industry, and it's hard to do.
So, one of the things that's also hard to do is to talk on the voice of the consumers in developing countries. And this honoree, we hope many of you will see in the trade facts of the week next week. So tonight's Lighthouse Award goes to Ed Gresser.
What's your job? What do you do? to WITA for his honor for the opportunity to work with them and work on events and help to bring some facts and knowledge about the basics of what we do to the Washington trade community and to people who are outside and look at trade as something that is a little intimidating, I think a little hard to understand, and really isn't all that hard to understand if you put a bit of work to it. I feel I've been so lucky in my career to work with Senator Baucus and to work with Charlene Barshefsky and with the DLC and BBI and now the GlobalWorks Foundation to do something I've loved and to do to try to bring a bit of fun and also a bit of serious study to one of the really important things that the American government does and followed up through science and technology or through consumers in the lives of the poor or through national security and advancing all kinds of subjects that I just love to work on. And above all, I have the opportunity to work with people that, you know, who I respect so much and who know so much and who teach me so much all the time. So thank you all so much. I'm really grateful to you, and I hope you enjoy this wonderful evening.